Second-class stamps thrust through my letterbox. I should have thought postmen would be trained to recognize first-class stamp houses.
It's not the post office puts the stamps on. It's the senders.
Oh, yes, of course. Blame the public. Would you please inform your supervisor that in future I want my stamps adjusted upwards?
How do I look? I want your opinion. Is this appropriate for business wear? You two don't just sleep, you hibernate. Oh, is that Onslow's beer I see spilling out onto the floor?
Oh, nice. Up after the night with your eyes, Cynthia, now there's some other comedian. I wish you'd bog off. Still in hyacinth aftershock.
Don't go back to sleep. Tell me how I look.
What makes you think I can see?
Daisy!
Ah, Daisy!
Oh, woof, woof. If it's our hyacinth come back, I'm not in.
But she's not come back.
I'll say this much for your hyacinth. She leaves a lot of happiness behind her. It's such a relief when she's gone.
How do I look?
For doing what? For selling costume jewellery door to door. Am I dressed properly for business?
If you get arrested for that kind of business.
One of these days, you'll find me lying in a pool of blood.
Listen to this. Wanted, managing director, Frozen Foods. Only persons of proven ability should apply for this senior position.
Why are you telling me this?
Because it's you, Richard. It's absolutely you.
Frozen Food.
Oh, not that bit, dear, but personal. And the firm is Frosticles. Their factory is only a few miles down the road. You could be home for lunch every day.
Wait a minute, Percy.
You could have the firm's car, probably a chauffeur.
Yeah, hang on, are you suggesting that I should apply?
Well, not through the normal channels, dear. I mean, what's the point of knowing people if one has to apply through the normal channels?
Do we know people?
Oh, not just people. We know Frosticles himself. Or at least Mrs. Frosticles. The Milburns! is. That thrusting creature on the ladies' luncheon committee. She was a Hackett from Wilton Street before she laid herself shamelessly in the path of frosticles. We must make sure that he knows you're available.
Sit there and practice being firm. All you have to do is say no.
Have you ever tried saying no to Hyacinth?
Liz, she's just a human being. Just. Look, you're a free spirit. If you don't want to go round there for coffee when she asks you, say no.
It doesn't make any difference. She never listens anyway.
All right, we'll rehearse it. You sit there practicing steely determination, and I shall pretend to be Hyacinth. Greater love hath no man for his sister than to be Hyacinth. Right, here we go. Phone ringing. We'll answer it.
Hello?
Coffee at 11, Elizabeth.
Thank you, Hyacinth. Now, the first thing to do is to get you to meet Mr. Milburn, Frostigles himself. No underlings. Go straight to the top.
I don't know the man.
Of course, it'll have to look like a chance meeting.
Oh, you're not going to start plotting me into something. I still blush when I remember how you tried to make me president of the archery club.
We were doing splendidly until you shot Mrs. Lazenby. I've never heard such a fuss. It was only a glancing wound.
You get it wrong. We always get it wrong.
Richard, I'm doing this for you, dear. It is my duty to give you a new vision for the future.
In frozen foods.
In a senior executive position.
I'll get frostbite.
Oh, Richard.
Bits of me start falling off. I can't apply for a position like that.
Of course you can't. You don't think that these senior executive positions are filled by application. It's always done by people knowing people. People upon whom one has made an impression on social occasions.
But where am I going to make an impression on old Frosticles?
On the golf course.
Hyacinth, that is not a good
idea.
Leave
it to me, dear. He'll probably be on the course this evening. But relaxing after a day's executing, then you come along looking ruthlessly efficient.
You mean this time I'm going to clobber Mrs. Frosticles? That was a lot better. Let's have another go. And remember, Liz, you're a woman not to be trifled with. Right, here we go again. Phone's ringing.
Hello?
It's only me, Elizabeth. Coffee at 11.
No, thank you, Hyacinth. Some other time.
See?
a question of getting started, isn't it? Once you've started, it's quite easy. And you are very good. You really sounded like Hyacinth.
I must ask you to never repeat that in front of a living soul.
Go on, answer it.
Hello? Coffee at 11? Thank you, Hyacinth. Now let me see you, Richard. And remember, first impressions.
The trouble is, I don't do impressions.
No, Richard. I want to see a captain of industry. You mustn't let Frosticle see you looking indecisive like that.
I feel indecisive. I'm happy with indecisive.
Richard, when Frosticle first claps eyes on you, you must be looking forceful and executive.
I shall be forceful and executive, Hyacinth.
Good.
I can feel it now, coming up through my knees. Oh, here it comes, up through my groin.
Richard, what kind of language is that for a senior Frosticle? Next!
Right, please. You failed on telephone. Let's try it face to face.
With Hyacinth?
Yes, of course, with Hyacinth. Just tell her to her face that you haven't got the time to accept her invitation to coffee.
Can I do it on the telephone?
You failed telephone.
I shall fail face to face.
Forceful and executive. I'm forceful and executive.
Oh, it's you, Elizabeth. Little early, dear, but do come in. Actually, Hyacinth, I came to tell you the angry garden, too.
Well, no, actually, I can't. I've got so many important things to do.
Do sit down, my dears, anywhere. Except this. That one for me. All right.
Hmm? Why, dear?
Well, he passed us on the doorstep and I thought he looked a bit preoccupied.
Oh,
he's got a lot on his mind. He's toying with various offers for a senior executive position in industry. Now make yourselves comfy. And if you'll excuse me, I'll just go and wipe Emmett's footmark off my woodblock. To take your shoes, Emmett. Come along. We don't want a repetition on your way out, do we? Of course, Richard and I never have this problem because we always wear leather.
Don't say a word. She'll sing at me. Now she has me trapped and barefoot. Heaven knows what she'll do.
Well, just don't let me spill the coffee. back in a jiffy. Gumbo, we are together. The merrier we shall be. The bouquet residence, the lady of the house speaking. Oh, it's you, Daisy. How are you, dear? Listen, Daisy. Tell Onslow to put a shirt on while I'm on the telephone. I can always sense him there, expanding. Onslow's in the garden. Daddy's gone naturist. Well, I think that's wonderful at his age. Yes, all that wholesome, healthy food. Plenty of roughage. Onslow's trying to get Daddy down from where? Well, why would Daddy be up there? Oh, he's not that kind of naturist. But what kind of naturist is he? A stark naturist. So glad you could pop in. We must do this again very shortly.
Well, that was quicker than I thought.
I forgot her coffee.
My favorite brand, too.
Where have you put Father?
He's back in his bed, fast asleep.
Is he wearing pajamas?
Says it's against his convictions.
You're great in a crisis, Onslow.
What crisis? Have we run out of beer? Oh.
Just now, you were magnificent. I could see you in full profile as you went past, carrying Father.
Hope you couldn't see him in full profile.
You were wonderful, Onslow.
Not that he's heavy, it's just without any clothes on at his age, there's not much to get hold of.
And you did it all for me. I wish there was some way I could repay you.
Listen, Daisy, when I promised to love, honour and obey, I didn't necessarily mean every Tuesday.
How long has your father been a naturist?
I think there must be some mistake. Daddy's always been C of E.
Do they take their clothes off?
I think it's a cry for help, dear. Mind the lorry.
She's only left.
And there's no lady on the pavement.
I'm on the road, so everything is as it should be.
Thank you.
could have Daddy at home, but he does so monopolize the bathroom. How can a place look like this 50 years after the Blitz? As soon as I'm quite sure Daddy's got all his clothes on, we must go and practice our golf, Richard.
Can I ask you to face a little reality here? I'm terrible at golf.
It's all right. He's finished being a naturist. He fell in some nettles.
Morning. Suppose you've got to go and put a coat on.
No, no, no! Stay just as you are. You make a very powerful first impression dressed like this, Onslow. I should like you to do me a little favour. Colourful, Richard.
Is Plan A with a touch of Plan C.
Hyacinth?
Who else?
To sneaking off for a chucker of golf. There you are, dear.
I didn't know you were so keen, Hyacinth.
Oh, yes, dear. Richard's practically a fanatic. Come along, Richard. We want to get through the full 16 holes. Have a good chuck, huh? Come along, Richard. We haven't got all day. Now try to look as if we're meant to be here. Yes, this is the place.
For what?
The place where you will impress Mr. Milburn.
Hyacinth, I'm not frosticle material. I'll never make a frosticle.
Richard, the refurbishment of the dining room is depending on your career as a frosticle.
Golfing disaster that I am, I do know that we're supposed to keep out of this stuff.
They'll think we're looking for a ball.
Oh, yes, I can do that. Looking for a ball. Now you're talking my game.
And it won't really be a lie, dear, because we are looking for something.
What?
Yeah, this is roughly where your Hyacinth sat.
And she said don't wear a shirt. Are you certain she said that?
That's what she said. I expect she wants me casual for golf.
Why would she want you at all for golf?
She knows I have sporting interests.
You watch racing on telly.
I don't just watch it. I put bets on.
It's not like our Hyacinth. She usually goes spare when you don't wear a shirt.
All I know is she said there'd be a month's supply of beer and crisps in it. And if things go right, as much frozen food as we can eat.
Frozen food? She's bribing you with frozen food? What's she up to?
All I have to do is wait in the trees over there until she raises her club in the air as a signal. Then I have to show myself.
Show yourself?
Just stand on the edge of the golf course, looking all male and menacing.
Why?
I don't know why. But for a month's supply of beer and smoky bacon, I don't care why.
It's your body. Our Harrison's getting fascinated with your body.
Oh, nice.
Will you know this Milburn when you see him? He won't necessarily be covered in icicles, you know.
Him. I stood very close to him once at the railway station.
Oh, you know him that well. So what am I supposed to do when he comes?
Plan A, dear. Remember, I shall give a signal to Onslow, who will emerge from the bushes and just stand there. The Milburn party will espy him and know that he's up to no good.
How will they know he's up to no good?
Because that's the impression Onslow always makes.
So he's standing there up to no good.
Then I shall say in a voice loud and clear, Richard, will you please do something about that suspicious-looking person? You will then walk towards Onslow and throw him out. And so the Milburns will be bowled over by your executive potential.
Your eyes, she looks a right muffin in that golfing gear.
It's been a long time since you brought me into the woods, Onslow.
Now, don't start getting broody. First with a leaf mould and you're off.
Me, Tarzan, you used to say. You, Jane, then you used to beat your chest and chase me through the woods.
Those were the lessons, Daisy. We had one-track minds in those days. I was full of hormones. We wasted all our educational opportunities. The number of times we went into those woods. We never once noticed a squirrel, did we?
Richard, here they come. Start looking executive. He's the one in the red trousers.
Couldn't work for anybody who wears red trousers.
Now, on my signal, Richard. Ah!
Never seen anything like it.
Suicide mission. Admire the fool's nerve. Very rare quality these days. Such stupidity. Well done, that man. Thank you, madam. And congratulations to your husband.
He's a dynamo, to his fingertips, bless him. I've known him throb away quietly, even in repose.
Done it, dear. They were impressed.
Can we go home now?
Of course not, dear. We'll finish the round, and then we get chatting to Mr. Milburn in the club. But I do believe he... Yes, he is. Mr. Milburn's coming. He's going to invite us to join him. I told you you'd made an impression.
I say, would you mind? Do you think your husband could do his stuff again? We've got a couple of offensive types up there. Need to be taught a lesson.
Richard, how wonderful. He's leaning on you already, dear. Off you go then, dear. Go on.
Come on, hurry up. Let's see you get the little ball down the hole.
I should watch your stuff. This chap's dynamite. I've seen him deal with bigger lads than you.
Oh, yeah?
Not so good this time.
Hello, missus. Come, walkies. Want to play games, do you?
Oh,
He's magnificent.
Richard. Richard. I've been offered a job with Frosticles.
Oh, take it, Hyacinth. Please.
I couldn't do that, dear. You'd be so bored at home without me.